Welcome to EA Sports live coverage of League One. It's Oldham Athletic against Gillingham. And your commentary team of Martin Tyler and Alan Smith.
Welcome, everybody. Martin Tyler along with Alan Smith. Alan, looking forward to it today.
Yeah, I think so, Martin. There's a really good buzz in the air here.
Alan, what about Oldham Athletic in this game?
Oh, they've endured the kind of run that most teams do during the course of the season. It's been really poor for them, but a chance for them here to pick themselves up and maybe get a win.
And it is a goal kick. He's into the challenge. Danny Phillips-Kirk. News of a goal from elsewhere, Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Bristol City. 9 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. In a goal, he's got a shoot. That's not going to be a winning ticket in the raffle, if you like. It's well off the target. Well, the home team will be pleased to see the visiting team sheet, because one of those main strikers who could certainly come here and hurt them is out injured.
Yeah, and on his travels this year, Martin, he has nicked one or two goals away from home, so that is a blow.
McDonald. And the referee blows his whistle. The flag was up for offside. He's been in very, very disappointing form. I think he's surprised that he's been picked for the starting 11 here.
Yeah, well, sometimes you've just got to try and play your way through these periods of bad form. Sometimes you're not able to, but he's got to keep his head up, keep his chin up.
Martin. Here's Lee. Oldham Athletic look a really good side these days. They're gunning for another win after that away victory against Tranmere Rovers.
Yeah, quite a straightforward 2-0 win for them, and I've got a feeling they're going to carry that on here with another win.
Lee. Danny Phillips-Kirk. Some potential in this move, and it's Weston. Lee. Strong cross, just too strong in the end. Not sure it was your forte, the slide tackle, but what about this one?
Well, it's this lad's forte, because he really just nicked the ball away cleanly.
The man who makes it tick in midfield for the home team, the creative midfield player, he can't play today, he's injured.
Yeah, and maybe that creative spark will be missing, but maybe have to create chances in different ways, going out wide, get crosses in.
And the defenders just managed to deal with that. Weston. Goal news from Brentford.
It's a goal for Tranmere Rovers. 24 minutes played, 1-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. Here's McDonald. The opposition back off, they could be in trouble. And the ball gets to here.
Oh, in goes the cross.
Cross is blocked here. Can he turn away from the challenge here? McDonald. Gonna cross it. Well, the away team, it's always tougher for the away team, and they come here with just 5 points from their last five league games.
Yeah, it's been a little bit drab from their point of view. Not much excitement in their game at the moment.
Phyllis Kirk. McDonald. To Green. Diagonal pass switches the play. Here's the chance. That is how close they came to getting the lead. Just checking back as we tend to do, Alan, over the last five league games for the home team. 9 points.
Disastrous by any means, but there are aspects of the game I think that they would need to improve upon to get that better.
Barrett. Lee. McDonald. To Green. To the attack now. He came across absolutely determined to get that ball. Oh, he's won the ball in his own penalty area. Got to deal with it now. Green. Very quickly. He really connected, and he needed to from that far out. It was an ambitious effort, and it nearly produced a great reward.
He has scored from those kind of distances, not this time.
The home team manager has got a couple of difficulties to deal with, significant absentees today, but many of the regulars are there.
Yeah, I mean, that's just something that happens during the course of a season, and I think they'll be fine.
Brilliant technique in the tackle to Green. News of a goal from Colchester.
It's a goal for Swindon Town. 41 minutes played, 1-0.
Cheers, Alan. Looking to widen the play, really, widen the build-up, but the ball's just run straight out over the touchline. Now Brown. Danny Phyllis-Kirk. Challenges for the ball. Into the attacking third. He can cross it now. Corner given. That's quite a disappointing corner, really. Now they're passing the ball well. Is in. It's got to be a goal, surely.
And here's the shot.
Oh, got in the way. Great block. So it's half time, and we're still waiting for that first goal. I think the manager's going to say at half time, well, keep doing the same, and you will get a goal, because they've opened up the opposition time and time again.
I think that's dead right.
It is a key moment in the match, really. And the manager here not settling for level pegging. He's going to try and do something to put his team into the lead. Nicely controlled football, this. Not rushing it, not forcing it, just keeping the ball, moving the opposition around.
Well, that's gone behind for a corner.
Looked a bit panicky from the defender.
And here's the shot. And the block there, stopping a goal, I think.
And that's offside. The referee has stopped the play as soon as the flag went up. There's some potential in this move. Gets his foot in there. Quickly by the opposition. And Weston. A goal from Rotherham.
It's a goal for Rotherham United. 53 minutes, please. 1-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. The opposition back off. They could be in trouble. And the ball gets to here. Here's Brown. Danny Phillips-Kirk. McDonald. He takes the shot. It wasn't the goalkeeper, it was one of his teammates that blocked the shot. Gregory. That's a turnover in play. Penalty at Rotherham.
It's a penalty for Walsall.
Could it be? He might be needed again, the goalkeeper. Goodness, they needed him then to clear that. Well, now we are going to have a substitution. And at this stage of the game, it's still level. This is what the manager will hope will be the decisive moment. I don't like to use the word panic, but I think it's appropriate here. And Weston. Team about to make a change. Great challenge by a player who's been doing that all game. On to the attack now. To Green. He's looking for the cross. Looked a bit panicky from the defender. Still waiting for the first goal. The goalkeeper's responsible for that. Substitutions at this stage, the key moments really, and the manager deciding to bring this player on to try and tilt the match, which is level, in their favour. And Smith. They're marking as tightly as they can. This corner could be a problem. They've got to defend it well. That's quite a disappointing corner, really. Now Green. McDonald. Brilliant pass there. really well done. Good defending. Goal news from Colchester.
It's a goal for Colchester United. 70 minutes played, 2-1.
Cheers, Alan. Got the ball away from the opposition, got to keep it now. McDonald. Won back very quickly. Into the face of the opposition. Now from Brentford.
It's a goal for Brentford. 74 minutes played. 1-1.
Thank you very much, Alan. Now Green. And back it goes. He's got that and cleared the ball away and saved his side from a difficult situation. Going to be a substitution here for the home side. Here's Brown. Danny Filliskirk. Teammate free in the centre. Now Brown. We'll get it back here. Here's the cross. And look at him again. He's got the clearance away. Wasted possession. News of a goal from elsewhere. Alan McInally.
It's the second goal for Bristol City. 10 minutes remain. 2-2.
Thanks, Alan. McDonald. Manager thinking for the away side. Time for a change. McDonald. Now Green. And in goes the cross. Tried to steer it in with the volley. And that will be a corner brought on by the manager here. And I wonder whether he can nick his first goal for his new club.
Sometimes it's easier coming off the bench. You know, the opposition are tired a touch, a bit more space. Let's see.
That would have been a fantastic goal. Positioning and the interception is made. I've seen this so often with these two teams. A late goal can decide it. It would decide it if we get one now. That's an important challenge at this time. Some players limbering up for the away team. Substitution in the offing. Now Green. He's coming forward with some danger. Tackled well. Martin. That's good pressing play from this team, and the tackler in particular. Surely he's going to score here. Oh! Big moment in a big match. On such things, games are sometimes won and sometimes lost, and he'd love to have scored, but he didn't.
Yeah, a matter of inches. That's how close it was to finding the back of the net.
We might look back at the end of the match at this decision, one way or another. The scores are level, and on he comes to try and tilt the game his team's way. Given the free kick. Game over, and It's 0-0 here. Well, possession wasn't everything today.